In this video, I'm going to show you my method to quickly morph between any two shapes, quickly and easily. So we want this triangle to morph into that square. The method I'm going to show you is super versatile. It will work on any shapes and you can apply lots of the principles to a bunch of non-shape morphing scenarios. First, let's open up our position property on our triangle, keyframe its current position, and a few frames later, move it over to where our square is. Now, the key to a good transition is anticipation. Anticipation is the movement that happens before our main movement that builds up energy and lets the viewer know, hey, look, get your eyeballs over here, something is about to happen. Adding anticipation is one of the biggest things you can do to improve your animation. For anticipation here, our triangle is going to move very slightly to the left before it morphs across the screen to the right. So let's add another keyframe position closer to the start, and then another one about the same distance after, because we're going to make our shape overshoot as well, where it goes a little further than it needs to and then settles back down into position. On our second keyframe, let's nudge our position a touch to the left. And on our third keyframe, a touch to the right, just using our arrow keys. And let's hide our square as well, we don't need to see that for now. Now the triangle moves over to the left slowly, zooms over to the right, and comes back a little to rest. To make that all feel smooth and natural, let's add some easing. First, I'm going to right click on its position and click Separate Dimensions. Because we're only animating its X position, any Y axis information is just going to get in our way. So let's delete those Y position keyframes. Now let's select our X position keyframes and jump into our graph editor by clicking over here. This is a representation of our X position over time. It goes to the left, goes to the right very fast, and then comes back left again. Let's select all of those keyframes and click the Easy Ease button down here to ease that motion and get some bezier handles. Here's what that looks like. And now we're going to adjust these so that the ease in and the ease out are really gradual. So let's pull out the beginning and end handles as long as we can. There, that's looking better. Now let's make this main movement a little quicker and more explosive. We can do that by facing these handles towards each other and making this curve a little bit steeper. But we don't want these edges to be that long, so let's bring those down a touch. Now let's take a look. Good, we're almost there. I'm going to tinker around with these for a few minutes to get that feeling a touch more natural. Because the better this motion is, the better the whole effect is going to be. There we are. I'm also going to add some rotation to exaggerate that motion. I'll place some rotation keyframes in the same areas as our position keyframes. Turn the second one a bit to the left, the third one a bit to the right, then go into the graph editor and make a similar curve to our position keyframes. If you haven't installed, the free plugin EaseCopy is very handy for copying ease values. Now here's our animation. It's looking good, but there's no shape morphing, nowhere to be seen, so let's fix that. At the end of this animation, let's make our square visible, and then parent it to our triangle by using the pick whip here, and selecting the triangle. Now they are both attached. And let's drag the end of the triangle layer to the middle here, where the animation is at its fastest. And let's trim the start of our square to the same point as well. So now our shape switches in between these two frames. Let's take a look. For a lot of scenarios, this is all you need. The anticipation and smooth easing make it so you barely even see the cut. But because all animators are show-offs and want everyone to know we morphed a shape like a big damn animation hero, we're going to draw their attention to it with some shape path animation. Let's search for our path property over here in the timeline. And I want to select both their paths and right-click Convert to Bezier Path so they're both editable. Let's add keyframes to both of those paths. Let's add an extra keyframe at the beginning of this big movement on the triangle, and one at the end of that big movement for the square. And we're going to focus on the cutting point between the shapes here. Let's zoom in a touch. For the triangle, I'm going to select our pen tool from up here. I'm going to move back this vertex here. And with our Convert to Vertex tool from up here in the toolbar, I'm going to drag it out over that vertex to create a rounder shape. And I'm also going to round the other corners too slightly. Here, I want it to look like the back of this triangle is moving a bit slower and leaving a trail behind it. I'm going to easy ease that first keyframe with F9 on my keyboard. Let's take a look. There. Not bad. Now let's adjust the path of the square to make a similar shape. Now that's a shape morph if ever I've seen one. But let's add some extra elements and secondary motion to really impress those strangers on the internet and hope to scrape together some self-validation. We can add another keyframe to our square path here and then adjust this square path keyframe. So it looks like that trailing section of the shape has caught up and is deforming the square inwards. There we go. And let's add this blob that flies off from our square because it's just got too much momentum for us to handle. This is just a shape layer, and I've got a few keyframes adjusting its position, rotation, and scale, appearing when our square is at its furthest point to the right. For this second blob section here that's attached to the square, which I've called blob 2, I drew the shape on a separate shape layer and keyframed its path property. Each frame is touching blob 1, and then eased into a flat edge, going back into the square. Sometimes it's faster to just draw a shape for 4 or 5 frames instead of some tricky After Effects morphing hack. Then I've also added this squiggly texture, which is just a comp with this shape inside with no fill and then a pink stroke. I just parented that to my triangle and then selected Preserve Underlying Transparency over here. So it's only visible on already visible areas underneath, which is our Mighty Morphin shape. Last of all is this shading layer, which is just a pink shape that I've added a Gaussian blur to, parented to my triangle, and then also added Preserve Underlying Transparency as well, so that it as well is also confined to our existing shape layers. Then I've added this whole comp to a dramatic space background, because this is just the type of stuff that happens all the time in space.
I've made a short playlist of some related videos that I think you'll enjoy if you've made it this far. I'll see you in the next video, and please consider subscribing if you'd like more of these videos every week.